हेलो बच्चों, होप यू ऑल आर गुड। ओके, नाउ वी आर कंटिन्यू आवर व्हाट एवर आवर प्रीवियस कंसेप्ट, दैट इज एडवांस कंसेप्ट ऑफ आवर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम। ओके, सो इन दैट एडवांस कंसेप्ट वी ऑलरेडी स्टडीड फोर क्वांटम नंबर्स। दैट फोर क्वांटम नंबर्स इज व्हाट? प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर, देन व्हाट? योर अजीमुथल क्वांटम नंबर, ओके, मैग्नेटिक क्वांटम नंबर एंड स्पिन क्वांटम नंबर। ओके, सो इन दैट वे saw n is equal to 1, 1, then n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, 4. Okay, as like we saw values of our azimuthal quantum number also. In that, their values start from 0, 1, 2, 3. S for 0, P for 1, D for 2, and for F for values of 3. Okay, so magnetic quantum number also we saw. In that, we got actual number of orbitals in where? In orbitals, okay, in S one orbital, P three total orbitals, then D total 5, then F total 7. Okay, so these are all about magnetic quantum number. Now we are going to start our next, okay, rules for filling of orbitals, rules for filling of orbitals in an atom. Okay, so see here, rules, see. See, rules for filling orbitals in an atom. Okay, so very much important here. First rule, okay, and that name is what? See, Avogadro. What? See, what here? AUFBAU. Spelling is what? Avogadro, or we can say what? Avogadro principle. Avogadro principle. Okay, so see here, Avogadro principle here. Okay, their spelling. So see here, in Avogadro principle, what they are saying? So this German word, Avogadro means what? It is a German word. So that German word meaning is what? Okay, German word, this meaning is what? Building up, or we can say what? As you know, building up means construction. Okay, so we have to construct here. Okay, so this word meaning what is? Avoid. It is a German word. Okay, meaning is what? Construction or building up. So what they are saying here, so your Avogadro principle gives us a sequence, okay, gives us what? Sequence. That sequence is what? Here electrons we have to fill in various subshells according to their increasing energy, according to their what? Increasing energy. So in electrons we have to what? Electrons we have to fill up with increasing energies. Okay, so in that obviously what will come? Whatever lower energy filled first, thereafter what? Higher energy. Okay, first that lower energy of whatever that maximum quota of electrons, that you have to fill first, then you have to move towards what? Maximum means for what? Higher energy level. Okay, understood. So these are what your above principle. So what is the statement of this principle? See here, The subshell with minimum energy is filled first, and when maximum quota of electrons, in that your minimum energy is completed, then we have to move towards what? Higher energy level. Okay, so like that we have to fill. Okay, so here actually it gives what? Avogadro principle, they gives us what? Sequence. Okay, in which sequence we have to fill up our subshell from lower to higher energy level. Okay, so they are giving us Avogadro. Okay, now see here, how that subshells we have to fill, that also we have to see. Okay, so see here how we can fill up that. So pay attention, very much important here, this thing. Okay, it is the advanced concept. So as you know, beta, here whatever your our periodic table, in periodic table we saw. So in periodic table, as you know, our from total how many periods and how many groups. So groups, as you know, groups are what? Yes, 18 groups and whatever horizontal 7 periods. So see, on the basis of that only we have to like, okay, right here. So see here, like that we have to do. From this, see, 1s, 2s, 3s, 4s, 5s, okay, 6s and what? 7s. Okay, as you know, these are what our period number means, horizontal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we saw in our periodic classification, our nature of our periodic table. Okay, so next is our, see, here 2p, 3p, 4p, 5p, 6p. Understood? Now next here sp, now d, 3d, 4d, 5d, spdf, that we are going to follow this spdnf. Now see here, after that 4f and what? 5. Now see here how we can do this electronic arrangement here. 1s, 2s, 3s, 4s, 5s, 6s and 7s. So total here 7 our what? Horizontal. Okay, horizontal what? Our periods. Now see here what we have to do after this, after writing this. So you have to do like this. See here, this 1s, okay, this 2s, like this we have to do. Okay, understood? So this, see this 1s, 2s, 3s. Okay, so see, after that we have to do here arrow. Okay, so this whatever it is, arrow. Now after this, say here what you have to do after this. Okay, see, so these are sequences like this. Okay, means this arrow means 1s, 2s. Okay, like this. Understood this arrow? So see this. Okay, thereafter what? Yes, like this. Means 1s, 2s, 2p, 3p, 4s. Then what here? Yes, 3d. This sequence. Okay, so very much important. See this arrow again here. Like that we have to do. Okay, see here, are you able to see this all? Okay, after this, like this. Okay, so see, like this. Understood? So this sequence you have to keep in mind. Okay, so we are writing, we can write here, means whatever this sequence. So see here, 1s, 2s. So with the help of increasing energy also we can write 1s, then what? 2s, increasing energy. Then 2p, 3s, okay. Then 3p, 4s, then what? 3d, 4p, 5s, okay. Then 4d, 5p, 6s, then what? 5d, 6p, 7s. So like that we have to do. Understood? So this is very much important, you concentrate on that, how I prepared this, and you have to keep in mind this all. Very much important. It is for your higher standard, but it is an advanced concept that you are studying in what? In 9th standard only. Okay, it is a benefit for you. Okay, so see here, after this we can write here, say how we can write with the help of increasing energy. So this sequence you keep in mind like this, zigzag manner. See, are you able to see this arrow also? So the zigzag manner, not directly start from this. First 2P, 1S, 2S, 2P, 3S, okay, then 3P, 4S, like that you have to fill what electrons for higher atomic number also. Okay, now we will see here one of the important rule. Okay, so see that rule, how we can write. See, with the help of increasing energy, we can write here, see, with on the base of this. 1s, are you able to see here? Okay, 1s, then what? Yes, 2s, then what? Yes, 2p, then what? 3s, then after 3p, then what? 4s, then what here? 3d, after that what? Yes, 4p, then what? 5s, and so on we can write. Understood? So like that, you have to keep in mind this order of this sequence of subshell in the order of increasing energy, and like that we have to fill the electrons in that. Understood? So it is the advanced concept, it is the 11th standard concept. Okay, so keep in mind this. Now see, after that we will say one important rule here. Okay, say one important rule in that N plus L rule. What beta? Here N plus L rule. N plus L rule. So N plus L rule. So as we saw, according to the sequence, which sequence in which various subshells are filled. Okay. That can also be determined with the help of, so whatever filling of electron, that also can be whatever that filling of electron, we can also be determined on the basis of what? N plus L rule. Okay, or we can say N plus L value. Okay, so see here, whatever a principle of, say principle of N plus L rule. So very much important is principle. Okay, so see, I'm writing here that principle. The subshell with the subshell with, okay, lowest N plus L value, lowest N plus L value is filled first. Okay, it's filled first. Okay, that this you understood. The subshell with lowest N plus value is filled up first. Okay, but like that condition occur when, what will happen say here, when two or more subshell have same N plus L value. When two or more subshell having same N plus L value. So see here, when, okay, so see, when two or more subshell having same N plus L value. So but at that time what we have to do? So simple, at that time here we have to do, okay, then the subshell like that if you come, then the subshell with lower value of N is filled first. So very much important is principle, the subshell with N plus lowest N plus value is filled up first. Okay, here no issues. But when two or more subshell having the same N plus value, then the subshell with lowest value of N is filled first. So we will see here example also. Okay, in that we will see, we can saw here, whatever your subshell. Okay, on the base of our now we draw 1:2, okay, 2p with increasing energy. Okay, so see here that we will continue. Okay, now see here how we can fill this. So first you have to write here, subshell. What beta here? Subshell. Okay, after subshell here what? Yes, n is what? Your principal quantum number. Then L is what? Azimuthal quantum number. And after that what? N plus L value. N plus L value. So like that we can make here table. So for a better understanding. Okay. So subshell, as you know. Okay. So see here. 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s. Okay. 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s. After that, what? 3d. Then what will come? Yes. 4p. Okay. After that, what will come? Yes. 4p. After that, what? 5s. Okay. So, like that, we can here. Right. Now, see here. Are you able to see this? So, see. 1s. So as you know here, beta, principal quantum number is what? Yes, n. Principal quantum number is what? N. So what is the value of this? Yes, n is equal to here 1 only. Plus L is what here? What is the value of your S for azimuthal quantum number? Yes, 0. So here what will come? 1 only. Are understood? So here what, beta? N is equal to that we know. N is what? Our principal quantum number means n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Now here what? 0. So here also what? 2. Now see here 2. Then here what? Yes. For p here value what? 1. Understood. Okay. Now here see 3 and what is value? Azimuthal quantum number value how much? 0. Okay. See here. Understood, n and l value. So n plus l. So here almost same. Now you are concentrating. Yes, see here. Here no issues. Here also no. Means sequence. Means first you have to fill this, then this, then this. But now see here, same value. It came. As I told in our in our n plus l rule, when two value with a what? Same subshell, it came. Okay. Then what we have to do? Filled with lower value of your n. That is what we are principal quantum number. Means among these two now, first you have to fill which field? Yes, here lowest value of n. So here, your first number, here what? Second number. Means first you have to fill this, then fill this. Okay, now we will proceed. Now see here 3. So here what will come? Yes, here what will come? 1 only. So 4. Now here what? 0. So here also what will come? And beta here 3. Now you are able to see here, beta, here 3p. So n is what? Yes, principal quantum number. P is what? Your 1. And 4, n is equal to 1, 4. And s is what? Your 0. So here see, here again we are to same. Having a same subshell. Okay. Different subshell having same value of n plus l. Okay. So at that time, see lower value of n. Means first you have to fill this. First number, then second number. Understood? Now see here, 3D. 3 and here d is what? 2. So that will 5 here. Now here 4. Yes. Here also what? 1. So here also 5. And here beta 5 and s value azimuthal quantum number 0. So here also what? 5 will come. So what we have to do here? Yes, here we have to again you are same. The value with lower value of n field first. Okay, so here 1, then 2, and then what? 3. Understood? So like that you have to fill. Understood? So we will write here now electronic configuration of few elements. Okay, you are ready with this electronic configuration of few elements. We will write. Okay, so say how we can write with the advanced concept. Up till now we are writing what with the help of our 1, 2, 1, 2, 2. Okay, now we are going to write here for advanced concept, and this is for your what 11th standard. Okay, so pay attention this electronic configuration of few elements. Electronic configuration, so say electronic configuration. Okay, electronic configuration of elements. So we will write here. Okay, so see that how we can write. Okay, so here one method in order to represent the electronic configuration, okay, of an orbital. So here we have to take principal quantum number before that subshell. Principal quantum number before that subshell. Suppose you are writing for your helium. Suppose you are writing for helium. So helium how much? Yes, atomic number 2. So beta, principal quantum number you have to write before, means here what? 1, principal quantum number 1. Okay, because our starting from what? 1s. So after that what? Orbital, that orbital, and how much electrons present in that elements, that we have to write near the top head of that particular subshell like this. So here 2, so here also what? 2. Means here maximum quota of this electron is completed according to our 2n square. We are writing like this, this nucleus, then first shell. So suppose we are writing for helium. So electronic configuration, atomic number 2. So 1s2 will come, because in 1 first shell how many maximum electrons? 2. So here maximum quota here completed. Now suppose if you are writing for lithium, then what will come? Yes, suppose we are writing for lithium. Okay, so see here lithium. So here what will come? Yes, 3. Okay, atomic number as you know 3. So here not will come 1s3, because here maximum quota of first shell is completed. Okay, so next energy we have to take, next is what? 2s. Understood? So 1s2 and what will come? Comma 2s1. So 2 plus 1 3. Understood? So like that we have to locate. Okay, so this one is what your principal quantum number, this is what your subshell, and this is what number of electrons. 2 is what your number of electrons. Understood? So here whenever you are writing for lithium, suppose this nucleus, your first shell, then what your second shell. So here for first shell maximum quota of electron is completed for first shell. Now it we have to require second shell like this. So 2, we are writing up till now what? 2, 1 up to 10 standard, it is correct. But whenever you are studying this advanced concept, that is the 11th standard. Okay, so how we can write electron configuration like this? 1s2, 2, 2s1. So 2, 1, 3. Understood? Like that. Now we will discuss all history of our how we can filling up orbitals. Okay, understood? So basically these are what we took here, some examples. Okay, now see here, after that suppose you have to write for carbon. Okay, suppose you have to write down for carbon. So for carbon, see here, as you know, carbon 6. Okay, so carbon 6, how we can write? 1s2, yes, 2s2. Then what will come here? Because as you know, s contain how many? S is 1 orbital, so it contain how much? Maximum 2 electrons. Okay, and after that what will come? See, your energy, increasing energy value 2p. So how much it required? 2. So this 2 is what becomes 6. Okay, so like that we are writing. Means here one more research, what will happen here for finding electronic configuration, why they require some advanced technique for this. Means this 2, okay, then 2s2, this 1s2 completed, 2s2, 2p2. So we are writing like this, 1 2 3 and 4. But how it will arrange? It will arrange among the s and p subshell. That is a discovery, or we discuss this as a deeply, in depth we discuss. Understood? These 4 whatever electrons, how it occur in 2s and 2p, means s and p subshell. Understood? And one of the important here, on the base of this we got information, means this p subshell, okay, p subshell also filled. Then you cross check, beta, these are your carbon is what? P block element. Last electron receiving that subshell, we call it as what particular block elements. Means last electron receiving this p subshell, so it belongs to where? Carbon is where? Your p block element. You can cross check in your periodic table. Your carbon is where? Carbon is where? In your p block element. Okay, so very much interesting these all. Okay, so these are what we saw, few examples of your electronic configuration. But up to 10 standard, what we have to write? Simply carbon 6. Okay, what? 2, 4. In depth concept, what it is? In front of you only, in depth concept. Okay, so understood. I hope you understood all these things. Okay, now we will see our next principle. Okay, or we can say that rule also. Say how we can write this Pauli exclusion principle. That what? Pauli exclusion principle. So this Pauli exclusion principle, what they are saying? Okay, so see here, according to this principle, no two electrons in an atom can have all. So see here, we will write in statement what they are saying. No two electrons, okay, no two electrons in an atom can have all the four quantum numbers, that is N, L, M and S, are what? Are identical. So very much important this, what they are saying. No two electrons in an atom can have all the four quantum numbers. That is, N is what? Your principal quantum number. N is what? Azimuthal quantum number. M is what? Magnetic quantum number. And S is what? Your spin quantum number. Okay, are identical. Means identical means what? See here, we can write here. Identical means what here? See, suppose N is equal to 1. So L is equal to 1. M is equal to also 1. Okay, this thing will never happen. Okay, see, we will see here one example. N is equal to 1. L is equal to also 1. And suppose M is equal to your plus 1. And, okay, your S is what? Plus half. Means this thing never happen. Because, suppose we are finding it is a meaningless. N 1, so beta 1, according to our azimuthal quantum number, 0 for S and 1 for what? P? one p is never, such type of orbital is never existed, one p. Okay, so that's why this statement is important. Understood? So we will see here some examples. Okay, as I told in spin quantum number also. Okay, so particular electron, we have got some values of our n, l, ml and what ms. So see here that values also. Okay, so you are concentrating on this. Now say your sodium, yes, sodium is what, 11, atomic number what, 11. Okay, so how we can write this in our 1s2 2s2 term? You can refer our whatever now energy, we draw like this zigzag manner. Okay, and we downside we wrote increasing energy level also, 1s 2s 2p 3s 3p. okay, so see atomic number 11, so say as like this, 1s2 2s2. okay, 1s2 2s2 2p6 and what, 3s1. What beta? 3s1. Now see here, these two, 4 6 10 and 11, understood? So as we saw in our, where in our magnetic quantum number only, for your p subshell, how many orbitals? 3. So 3 means what? It contains 2 electrons. So maximum how much? 6 only. Understood? So like that, 2 plus 2, 4 plus 6, 10, and this what? 1, 11 we got. Okay. So very much easy this again. So suppose we have to calculate value of, calculate value of n, l, m and s for 10th electron. What beta? For 10th electron in sodium. In where? 10th electron in sodium. So how we can write? So simple here. How we can write? So see how we can write this. Okay, very much easy. For 10th electron we want. Okay, so for that we have to clean this. I will show here. Okay, for 10th electron beta, so see here, 10th electron, where it is your 10th electron? So see 2 2 4, yes, here into p subshell. So here your 10th electron. Okay, so as you know, your n is equal to what will come? Obviously 2. Okay, understood? So what beta? Your l will come. P for what? Yes, your 1 will come. Are you understood? And for your ml, or simply a magnetic quantum number, what will come? We want 10 electrons. So like that we have to draw. See, your 3 total orbitals from according to our magnetic quantum number. So as you know, this 4, 2 to this 4. Okay, so 10th electron, we want information what? We want the values of this 10th electron. Okay, so 2p6. Understood? 2p6. Okay, but this 10th electron is in our, where? In your 2p6 orbital. Okay, so see here, 4, 5, 6, 7. First, we have to singly fill. That rule will come, Hund's rule of for maximum multiplicity. First singly filled, then pairing takes place. Means beta, after this 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, 8, 9 and 10. So we know for magnetic quantum number, what are their values? Minus L to plus L including 0. So beta, minus 1, 0 to plus 1. Say yes, here we got a 10th electron. So see, once again we will see, these two 4, we want the 10th electron information, their values. So 7, okay, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so this 10 you're here. So whatever your m is, value what? Plus 1. And in your spin quantum number value, that is your what? S. What it will come? spin down. Spin down means what? Minus up. Or we can say what? Anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise. Understood? So like that we have to calculate the values of what? We have to calculate values of our principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number and spin quantum number. Very much easy. Once you know all your quantum number, then it becomes what? Easy to calculate what their values. Okay. So we will see more examples on that. On which first we have to concentrate on first 20 element. From that it will come any element. For any electron we have to suppose calculate value. So we can calculate easily. But because you first know what is information, you have to read this all data. Principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number and what? Your spin quantum number. Okay. It becomes easy to remember. Okay. See here, next we will see. In that only, Pauli exclusion principle. Okay. In that only, Pauli exclusion principle, what they are saying? An orbital, okay, cannot have more than how much? 2 electrons. Okay, and small b is what saying? If an orbital has two electrons, it must be, yes, opposite spin means what? Like that we saw. Suppose this one orbital, s orbital, spin up and spin down. Okay, so like that, very much important here. Okay, now we will see here whatever our next rule, or we can say as a principle, that is Hund's rule for maximum multiplicity. Okay, Hund's rule for maximum multiplicity. Okay, so see what they are saying, Hund's rule for maximum multiplicity. This rule they are saying, okay, filling up of, okay, degenerate orbitals of the same subshell, degenerate orbitals of same subshell. Now this thing also I discuss, degenerate orbital of same subshell. So first you concentrate on, I think this word is new to you, degenerate. Okay, so degenerate means, see here, you can write here degenerate orbital meaning. Degenerate orbitals. So write down here degenerate orbital also. Electron orbitals which have same energy level. Electrons orbitals which have same energy level. Same energy level means as like this. So see how we can write same energy level. Okay, so same energy level means like this. We saw in carbon example only, carbon is what? 2,4 normal up to 10 standard. But here whenever you have to write for advanced concept, okay, 1H2, how you can write this? 1H2, 2H2, 2P2, okay, means these are what? same energy level. Electrons orbital which have same energy level. We can show diagrammatically also. So see here like this. Diagrammatically. First shell. Okay. Your first shell. And what your second shell? See here. First shell maximum quota of electrons completed. Then your what? Yes, second. Okay, so see 1, 2, 3, 4 means whatever these electrons in that orbitals are what? These are degenerate. Degenerate means what? Orbital which have same energy level. Same energy level. Okay, understood. So see here. Okay, so like that we can arrange here. Now, whatever these degenerate orbitals. Whatever your degenerate orbitals. Okay. So see here, we will see one example regarding degenerate orbital about your 2p. Okay. So see here, 2p, whenever you are writing like this, 1s2. Okay. Yes, as you know, s orbital how much? One only orbital. In that two electrons, how it will be opposite spin. Next is what? Yes, 1s2 or 2s2. Now see 2s2, it will also what? Yes, with opposite spin. And here what, beta? Yes, here what will come? Here not likely it will come. Hund's rule, what they are saying? Like this 2p2, here you have completed 1s2, here completed 2s2, here why it's time to fill electrons in 2p2. So it will not like this 1 and 2. It is wrong if you done like this. Hund's rule, what they are saying, first we have to fill singly, then pairing takes place. First electrons fill, we have to singly, then what pairing takes place. This is what you have degenerate. Okay, in same what, which have same energy level. 2p2 means first singly filled, then pairing takes place. Okay, like this. Now it will be what? You are correct. 2p2. And we will see again here example. Okay. Say, we will say here example again in degenerate orbital, same energy level. First you have to fill singly, then pairing takes place. Degenerate orbital in same energy level. See here like this. Suppose we are going to write down for nitrogen. 7, atomic number 7. So normal over what will come? 2, 5. But advanced electron configuration, how it will come? 1s2, 2s2. Yes, what will come? Okay. 2p1. So total how much? 7, no. So 2, 2, 4 and here 3. Sorry. 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. It has a tendency to 6 electron, no doubt. But here how much electron number 7? So that much only we have to fill. 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. 2, 2, 4 plus 3, 7. Understood? So how we can write in block diagram also like this? 1s2, it must be opposite spin. Following all our rule, follow exclusion above principle also. So you see here 2s2, it also opposite spin. So whenever we are going to write for 2p, okay, so 2p3 are there, it must be not like this. First use directly you filled up and pairing done, it is wrong. Then how it will be correct? First beta singly filled means as like this. See once again 2p3, 1 2 3. Okay, so see 2 2 4 3 7 means first beta singly filled, then pairing takes place. Then pairing. Okay, understood these all? So very much important is. Okay, so now it will be what? You are correct. First singly filled, then pairing takes place. Whatever your upcoming. Suppose we are writing for oxygen. Okay, suppose we are writing for oxygen. So how we can write? See here. How we can write? See here. Oxygen 8. So in normally we can write how? 2, 6 for advanced. 1s2, 2s2. Yes, to P4, same energy level, degenerate orbital. Okay, so how can we write here? Yes, 1s2, then what will come here? Then what will come here? 2s2, yes, understood. Now what here? To P3, so see here, are you concentrating on this? So, 2P4, first singly field, 1, 2, 3, then whatever your fourth is, paired up as like this. Understood? So, now it will what? Correct. Okay. So, we have to, whenever we have to write a value of N, L, M and your S, at that time, this small thing we have to keep in mind. Okay. So, we saw almost all our whatever advanced concept of our structure of atom. I hope you all understood everything. If you have any doubt, you can feel free to ask anytime. Okay. So we will now here I am saying our topic is completely whatever structure of atom. Okay. So thank you once again. Stay safe and take care. Thank you.